It must surely, in this day and age, come as something of a shock to the ordinary man in the street to learn that there still exists in this country a sect of people who are still genuinely convinced that the earth is flat. However, and I believe this to be only fair, one should never condemn out of hand the beliefs of others without first investigating those beliefs. And it is for this very reason, despite the fact that more than 400 years have elapsed since Magellan first circumnavigated the globe...
Oh, that word.
Circumnavigation?
No, the other one.
Globe?
Oh, yes, that word. We never use that. Never. It's forbidden by Article 19 of our charter. I ever use that.
Well, here in the studio, we have Mr. Jeremiah Fuller, the present secretary of the International Flat Earth Association. Now, Mr. Fuller, how many members have you at the present?
Well, sir. Excuse me. When we were first formed, sir, in 1922, membership was restricted entirely to the United Kingdom. And there was only three of us, including myself and my good lady wife.
I see.
But today, even as I speak to you now, we are 15 in number, sir. 15 in number. And this figure embraces two members in Dar es Salaam and five in Hong Kong.
Remarkable, quite remarkable. Now, Mr. Fuller, could you tell us very briefly just why you think the earth is flat?
Well, sir, I'm afraid one would need a much longer program than this in order to obviate the necessity of more than a brief resume of all the facets involved.
Mr. Fuller, have you never seen photographs taken from high-altitude rockets which distinctly show the curvature of the Earth?
Well, they're fakes, sir. They are fakes, every one of them. And I'd like to take the opportunity of making it public here and now that there is a worldwide conspiracy of leading statesmen and scientists to discredit our association and all it stands for, as laid down in its charter for their own secret and wicked purposes,
Come now, Mr. Fuller, this is a preposterous idea. You surely can't be serious.
You can see fit to jeer, sir. But the day of retribution will surely come when you and all the other jibing skeptics who mock us will be forced to repent of your heresy or be cast in the everlasting fire with sackcloth and ashes on your loins. And I say unto
you... Mr. Fuller...
I will be heard, sir. I will be heard. We waited years for a chance like this. As their spokesman of the International Flat Earth Association, I say unto you that the hour of the great reckoning is not so far distant as you might suppose, because, sir, by detailed studies of the scriptures, my colleagues and I have ascertained that the world be destroyed by fire on the 17th of every month.
But the 17th was yesterday, Mr. Fuller.
All right, I'm a day out then.
Correct me if I am
wrong. I'm a day out, that's all.
Please.
What's the day?
Mr. Fuller, correct me if I am wrong. You have already incorrectly forecast the end of the world on four separate occasions. According to you, we were supposed to have had doomsday in 1923, 1931, 1937, and as recently as 1950.
What are a few years here and there, sir, when measured against the limitless backcloth of eternity? What are they but as grains of sand?
Yes, thank you, Mr. Fuller, but do you mind very much if we get back to the subject in hand for a moment? Now,
grains of sand.
If, as you contend, the earth is flat, what happens if you keep on walking in a straight line?
You try and catch me that one, would you? Try and catch me. But you think you've got me there. Do you know, sir, it is an incontrovertible fact that every year thousands of people is reported missing from home and disappear without a trace. And what has happened to them? I tell you, they have simply walked off the edge of the world. Could anything be more obvious
than
that?
Have you any evidence whatsoever to support this fantastic and unbelievable theory?
Evidence, sir? What more evidence do you need? Verily, sir, I say unto you that when the trumpets shall sound out at Zion and Babylon on Judgment Day, all ye heretics who make sport of us shall be thrown into the bottomless pit together with the painted harlots and brides of Satan who now walk abroad in the streets trying to turn the thoughts of honest men to fleshly lust with their posturings and mincing gait. Posturings and mincing gait.
Please, turn the sound.
Wow, I say unto all these women in their summer dresses and bathing costumes whose rounded breasts and bodies curve in the evil shape in which unbelievers say the earth is curved. Let them be destroyed, even as Sodom and Gomorrah's.
Turn the control.
Wow, I say unto all things as bound and curved. Woe unto footballs, ping pong balls, tennis balls, billiard balls, cricket balls, cannonballs, marbles, and pawnbroker signs. Woe unto melons, apples, grapefruits, oranges, and lemons. Woe unto balloons, electric light bulbs.
For God's sake, turn the sound off!